because this is a, you know, very, this is a subject on which I wouldn't like to say anything now.
And the subject here is corporate governance. Indian realty players have seen a meteoric rise of sorts the last couple of years. Whether it is new projects, salaries, or double-digit profit margins, the realty story was part of India shining. But the last couple of months have seen some top executives of real estate companies move on from their big package jobs. Vipin Agarwal, former ED Operations, and Anand Parekh, former Director Corporate Strategy of OMAX, quit in the last 12 months. Amitav Ganguly, former company secretary, and Mahesh Maheshwari, former CFO, Ansal Group, also quit in the last 2 months. These exits have further dented the realty image. Of course, companies which had denied layoffs just months ago say that the resignations are part of a trimming exercise.
I think it's more of cost cutting. I think it's more of cost cutting rather than, you know, better opportunities for them, because I don't think too many sectors offering too many opportunities in today's times. So I think it's more as a cost cutting measure.
I think real estate companies are not able to sustain them. And they are not happy with the way that real estate companies are really operating, you know.
This largely unregulated sector with a host of family-owned companies and a bunch of listed firms does not score high on corporate governance. Since most transactions happen in cash, independent analysts say chances of fraud and diversion of funds are high, especially for unlisted small companies. An absence of a regulatory framework only fuels poor practices.
It is mostly controls. So when there are control mechanism, the different builders manipulate the control machinery in their favor. If they are uniform for everybody, then only you can bring uniform governance on part of the builders also.
The listed developers are required to follow certain basic guidelines regarding appointing independent directors, external auditors, and a certain degree of transparency. But the Satyam fiasco might just prove to be a wake-up call for the sector to tidy up before it's too late.
Like our ERP system, you know, we've been live for about a year and a half now on the Oracle, and you know, it gives a lot of information which we have not been, you know, reading that much, and so spend more time on, you know, getting the reports from them and, you know, understanding them and, you know, making more improvements from them, strengthening a little bit of our internal audits more. So I think more on those lines we are, you know, studying aspects.
There might just be a silver lining to India's biggest corporate scandal. It might just give the much required push to the real estate developers to have some concrete corporate governance practices in place. Of course, the Real Estate Act, which has been pending and seeks to set a regulatory framework for the developers, would help a great deal. But considering land as a state subject, here too the challenge would lie in implementation. Shweta Punj, UTVI, New Delhi.